Good afternoon, everyone. Previous session, we learned about the struggle to survive. So how the people, so they were struggled to get even a single piece of bread also. Why? Because the most, so because of increase of the population, so the food grains price, it's became so high. So everyone, they are struggling in the country, and even this led to a subsistence crisis. Are you getting now? So today's class, we are going to learn about a growing middle class envisages an end to privileges. A growing middle class envisages an end to privileges. So we know that during Louis administration, so by birth there were many, especially the clergies and the noble class people, so they were enjoying the privileges by birth itself. So afterwards what happened? So how it is going to be an end? That, so we know that, because the thing is that here the expenses of the government is so high, but the revenue or the different taxes were collected by only those who are belongs to third estate. So anyhow, let us see, a growing middle class envisages an end to privileges. A growing middle class envisages an end to privileges. An end to privileges. See, in the past, peasants and workers had participated in revolts against increasing taxes and food scarcity. So especially the shortage of the food and the economic crisis, and those who are struggling to live their life, so especially it was directly affect very badly on the peasants and worker class people. So they had participated in a revolt against the increasing taxes and food scarcity. What about other class? They were not worried about, because already they were, they may do not have those problems, because they were a rich class people, noble class people, clergy. See, but they lacked the means and programs to carry out full scale measures that would bring about a change in the social and economic order. Of course, because may guidelines or the leadership, maybe there is no the to lead and to demand. So even they were revolt against increasing taxes and also food scarcity. But the thing is that they lacked, they were not successful, because there are so many reasons. Why? Because no, the programs whatever, so the programs to carry out full scale measures that would bring about a changes in a social and economic order. See, this was left to those groups within the third estate who had become prosperous and had access to education and new ideas. See, it was begun in the third estate, because even in the third estate also, so there were so many educated class people, and there were so many the prosperous, because they were access to education, and because of education, so they were taught to, and they were came with the new ideas. The 18th century, it was witnessed the emergence of social groups which was termed as middle class. So this is what? The middle class. In the 18th century only, in a society, the new social group, it was emerged and which was termed as the middle class. See, the middle class people only carried their wealth through an expanding overseas trade and from the manufacture of goods, especially woolen and even silk textiles that were either exported or bought by the richer members of the society. Understood now? So, these middle class people, so who earned their wealth, some of the middle class people, they were earned their wealth. They gained. How? So, by expanding overseas trade, they were traded with other countries through overseas, and also they manufactured goods, especially the woolen and silk textiles, and that were either exported or brought by the richer members of the society. See, in addition to merchants and manufacturers, the third estate, it was included professions. We all of you know that already yesterday's session we learned that the structure of the French society, the third estate, it's including so many different people. Even the rich businessman, big businessman and traders, merchant, and even some of the other professionalists, lawyer. So like that, the educated class people also there we can see. See here, the third estate, we know that included professions, including the different professions who are practicing, especially lawyers and the even the administrative officials also, they are comes under the third estate. See, all of these were educated and believed that no group in society should be privileged by birth. See, all these educated class people, all these members, especially the government officials, the lawyers and the businessmen, all, so they were believed that. So about what? So in a society, no group in the society should be privileged by birth. Rather, a person's social position must depend on his merit. According to that, it should be decided. See, this idea envisages a society based on freedom and equal laws and opportunities for all. This is completely based on this idea only. So, whatever they came with the new ideas, so this ideas envisaging a society based on freedom and equal laws and opportunities to everyone. And also, they were put forward by philosophers. We know that there were so many philosophers during the time. They were composed their works and they were came with the new ideas. And even, so these middle class people, so they were these middle class people, so they are actually gained that knowledge also, the new ideas also, they learned and they gained, and then they were aware about all these ill practices which were actually done by the rulers or the monarchs. Especially the philosophers such as, I think you all of you know that the famous one, John Locke. Have you heard about John Locke? John Locke. See, he was one of the famous philosopher, and also J.J. Rousseau. J.J. means Jean Jacques Rousseau. So, in short form, so J.J. Rousseau. See, in his The Two Treaties of Government, Locke sought to refute the doctrine of the divine and absolute right of the monarch. Understood now? So actually, John Locke, so he was composed the Two Treaties of Government. It was written by John Locke. See, in his compose, so Locke sought to refute the doctrine of the divine and absolute right of the monarch. ಅವನ ದೈವತ್ವ ಅಂತ ಏನ್ ಅನ್ಕೊಂಡಿರ್ತಾರಲ್ಲ ಆ ರಾಜರ ನಿರಂಕುಶ ಅಧಿಕಾರವನ್ನ ಅವರು ಟೀಕಿಸ್ತಾರ. ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಜೆ ಜೆ ರೂಸೋ ಇ ವಾಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾರಿಡ್ ದ ಐಡಿಯಾ ಫಾರ್ವರ್ಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಪ್ರಪೋಸಿಂಗ್ ಅ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಗವರ್ನಮೆಂಟ್ ಎಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ಬೇಸ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ಸೋಷಿಯಲ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೇರ್ ರಿಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟೇಟಿವ್ಸ್ people and their representatives in his compose social contract. Understood now? So here the same idea, it was a forward by the Rousseau in his book Social Contract. So J.J. Rousseau, it was expressed in Social Contract. So according to Rousseau, the government, it should be specially so based on a social contract only between people and their representatives. Then the another one philosopher, Montesquieu, I think you all of you knows that Montesquieu name also, Montesquieu. He was also written a book, The Spirit of the Laws. So in this Spirit of the Laws, Montesquieu, so he was proposed a division of power within the government between the legislature, executive and the judiciary. So there we can see the democratic idea which we are actually following. Now we all of you knows that the three organs of the democratic government are legislature, executive and judiciary. So this concept, it was actually introduced in the Spirit of the Law by Montesquieu, was a famous philosopher. So according to Montesquieu, so a division of power within the government between a legislature, executive and the judiciary, that means, so it was actually during that time only given the proper idea of the democratic concept about the democratic system. The government should be, the power of the government should be divided into these three levels, legislative, executive and the judiciary. See, this model of government was put into force in the USA. So this, where the power of the government is divided within the legislature and executive and the judiciary, so actually during the time, so this type of government was put into force in the USA, and after the 13 colonies of United States, so they were declared their independence from Britain. Are you getting now? Actually, the 13 colonies of US under the control of Britain. So by declaring this type of government, so they were declared their independence from Britain. See, the American Constitution and its guarantee of individual rights was important example for political thinkers in France. Actually, we all of you knows that to gain their independence, even the France also helped. Even the France also helped to US to gain their independence. See, the idea of that, how the US, the 13 colonials, I mean the colonies, the different states were declared freedom from the Britain, and afterwards what type of government they were adopted, that is very clear, that is the democratic type of the government which was proposed by actually the Montesquieu in his The Spirit of the Law. So the same concept, it was a force, put into force in the US after that. So there we can see. See, this is what the main theme of the democratic system. The government, I mean, the power of the government, so it should be separated within this, the different organs. Especially, the power of the government should be divided into the legislature and the executive and the judiciary. So, this actually became a most important example for the political thinkers in a France country. See, the idea of these philosophers were discussed intensively in a public places such as even the saloon also, and even coffee houses, and even the people, they were spread among through books and even the newspapers also, and also these were frequently read about, allowed in a groups for the benefit of those who could not read and write, because when this, the new ideas and all, so how it was spread? So actually, the ideas of these philosophers, whatever they were expressed in their composition, I mean what they written, so the, all those things discussed intensively, even in saloon, even in the coffee houses, even in the public places, and spread among the people through books and newspapers also. And sometimes even, so these were frequently read loudly also in groups for the benefit of those who could not read and write. Because some of the people, those who are, they cannot write or they could not write and read, so to understand, so they read aloudly also, and those people also got this idea and knowledge. See, the news that Louis XVI planned to impose further taxes to be able to meet the expenses of the state generated anger and protest against the system of privileges. When? So, the news was spread through the different way about, especially the Louis XVI, again he was planned to impose the extra taxes to meet the expenses of the state. So, these rumors and this news, when it was spreaded among all French people, know, so this is, sorry, this was actually generated anger and protest against the system of privileges. I hope, dear students, you all have understood about this topic. So, once again, I would like to repeat briefly the same. So, we all of you know that, especially in the peasants and the worker class people, so they were revolt against increase in taxes and even the about food scarcity also during this time, but they lacked the means and programs to carry out full scale measures that would bring about a change in social and economic order. See, this was left to those groups within the third estate who had become prosperous and had access to education and new ideas. Because the third estate, it includes even the poor class people, even the peasants also, even the landless laborers also, even the servants also, and also the third estate consists of the lawyers and even government officials, big businessmen, merchants, and so on so. See, the 18th century, it was witnessed the emergence of the social groups, which was termed as a middle class. So, these middle class people, those who earned their wealth through, and they were also earned some of the wealth through an expanding overseas, and also from the manufacture of goods such as woolen and especially silk textiles that were either exported or brought by the richer members of the society. So, in addition to merchants and manufacturers, the third estate also included the professions such as the lawyers and administrative officials. See, all of these were educated and they were believed that no group in the society should be privileged by birth. They were all believed like this. These all educated people. So according to them, they believed that so no group in society should be privileged by birth. So rather, a personal social position must be depend on his merit. A person enidaralla avara merit mele adanna nirdhara madbeku. So even this ideas envisaging a society based on freedom and equal laws and opportunities for all. So it is about the freedom and equal laws and opportunities for every citizen. So even the same time, the philosophers, they were came with the new ideas. So already we have discussed about, especially John Locke, J.J. Rousseau and Montesquieu. So they were come and spread the new ideas, which were so new for the entire world. Especially, so John Locke, he was explained in his the two treatises of government. So about refute the doc, he was against, and it was written very clearly about the doctrine of the divine and absolute right of the monarch. He was against of this. So he was a refute and a refused the doctrine of the divine and absolute right of the monarch, because the kings, they were believed like, we born to rule you like that. So this is what the divine power given by the God. So they believed like that. So he was repute very clearly, so strongly in the two treatises of government. And the Rousseau, he was carried the idea forward, so proposing the government must be, so the form of government, so that must be based on a social contract between people and their representatives. It is like, so the basic concept of the modern democratic system. And after that, Montesquieu, so in his The Spirit of Law, so he was explained about the government. So a power of the government, or a division of power within the government between the legislative, executive and the judiciary. See, this model of the government actually was put into force in US also. So after that, 13 American colonies, so when they were declared their independence against Britain, they were declared their independence against Britain, because actually, so these American 13 American colonies, they were under the control of the Britain. So after that, when they were declared their independence, so they were adopted the new form of the government. So which is actually where the government power is divided into the different organs of the government, such as the legislature, the executive and the judiciary. So the American Constitution and its guarantee of individual rights was an important for example for especially the political thinkers in France. So these ideas, whatever brought by the philosophers, were discussed intensively even in coffee shops and even in saloons and different public places, and even so this spread among the people also through books and newspapers, and there were frequently read aloud in a groups for the benefit of those who could not read and write also. See, the news that Louis XVI, so he was going to, or he was planned to impose further taxes, especially to be able to meet the expenses of the government, that generated anger, and so these middle class people, so they were got ready to protest against the system of privileges. So the next class we are going to discuss about the outbreak of the revolution. Thank you. Have a nice day.